Hello! In this video, we are going to see how to deploy a CyberSense OVA. After deploying the OVA, we'll explain how to expand OptIE and Scratch Storage. CyberSense is an additional level of protection in cyber recovery that detects mass deletions, encryption, and other suspicious changes in core infrastructure, user files, and critical production databases caused by common attacks, including ransomware. To start deploying the CyberSense OVA, right-click the ESXi host and select Deploy OVF Template. Select the downloaded OVF file from the local system and click Next. Populate the virtual machine name and click Next. Click Next on the Compute Resource and Review Details page. Accept the license agreement and click Next again. Here we see that there are two configuration options available for the deployment. CyberSense Medium, which requires 20 CPUs and 192 GB of memory, and CyberSense Large, which requires 32 CPUs and 384 GB of memory. Select the required configuration and click Next. By default, Thick Provision is selected, which is recommended for better performance. Here we are selecting Thin Provision due to the space constraints for this demo. Click Next. To customize the template, we enter the FQDN, IP address, NetMask, Gateway, DNS and time zone settings, and NTP details and click Next. Review the summary page and click Finish to start the deployment. When the deployment is complete, right-click the VM, power it on, and launch the web console. Note that by default, Security Enhanced Linux and Firewall are enabled. The default admin password is admin. The system will prompt you to change the default password during the first login. Similarly, the default password for root is changeme, and you'll be prompted to change this during the first login. This completes the deployment part. Let's see how to expand the OptIE and Scratch storage. Why is this useful? The OptIE file system is where all binaries and log files are saved. Expanding it will help prevent it from running out of space. A Scratch pool is a local disk area used to support and accelerate the indexing of disk images, such as VMDKs. Using Scratch pools increases performance as compared to using remote access. First, we run this command to scan the device in the server. The command output shows that there are four disks attached to this server: A, B, C, and D. Let's exit the CyberSense VM and navigate to the vCenter GUI. Here, we'll add two 150 GB disks. For this demo, we'll specify thin provisioning, but for better performance, we recommend using thick provisioning. Let's go back to the CyberSense PuTTY session and again run the command to scan the device. Now we can see that there are two more disks attached to the VM, E and F. Run the fdisk-l command to identify the new disks and which file systems need to be increased. Label both the disks as GPT or GUID partition table using the parted command, first for SDE, then for SDF. Now, we'll create a new primary partition on SDE using the fdisk command. Type N and hit Enter at each prompt to the default values and create a new primary partition. Now we repeat this process for the other disk. This process created two devices called DevSDE1 and DevSDF1, which we can now see by entering the fdisk-l command. Now we use the pvcreate command on each device to create a partition to a physical volume. To extend the physical volume, we need to identify which volume group to extend. And to identify the volume group to extend, we use the vgdisplay command. By default, the OptIE volume group name is data, and the Scratch volume group name is scratch. To extend the OptIE file system, enter the command vgextenddata, devsde1. To extend the scratch file system, enter the command vgextendscratch devsdf1. This is not covered here, but you can verify that the volume group free size has increased by using the command vgdisplaydata grep free. Now, to extend the logical volumes, we need the logical volume path and the volume group name of each logical volume. To get the LV path and VG names, enter the lvdisplay command. To extend the opt.ie file system, enter lvextend command and specify the LV path. To extend the scratch file system, do the same. And finally, we can expand the mounted file systems using the xfs growfs command. Now we can see that both file systems have been expanded by about 150 gigabytes. This concludes the demo. Thanks for watching.